What's happening, everybody? We are coming at you with another one of our Blade Steel series. This one's going to be a little different, though. We've got some really cool stuff for you. But before we get started on continuing that Blade Steel series, if you like this video, smash that thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel, ring that notification bell so you will know when we drop new videos, not only in our Blade Steel series, but across the board. So you can see that knife show when it comes out. So you can see all our brand new exclusives when they come out. So you can see all the new knives and new outdoor equipment when we get them. So now, without further ado, let's light it up. So the debate over blade steel is one that has always and will always stir conversation among knife enthusiasts and users. Which one is the best? Well, that one is good for this application and not for this one, but this one is good for that application. And then, of course, there are the tried and true purists that avoid the hype and refuse to get sucked into the fanfare of every new blade steel that comes out. Now, regardless of where you stand or how you feel about blade steel, you can't deny the positive effect that has been made on the knife industry brought along by the development of new blade steels. That being said, there have been many that were touted as being the best, but few have really reached the level of fervor or buzz that Magnacut has this year. Also, most premium steels that have come along were not originally developed specifically for knife making. Most have been developed over the years as high-speed tool steels for the production of industry or for aerospace. After years of contemplation, studying steel and dissecting compositions and performance, Larrin Thomas actually decided it was time, and he wanted to come out with his own blade steel. He had done a lot of research and had really delved into the metallurgy to come up with some ideas of his own. So first he contacted Bob Shibala, which you've seen on our channel, to pitch his idea with all the information he had compiled. And with Bob on board, he went to Crucible Industries, which Bob, working with Niagara Specialty Metals, is the distributor for all of Crucible's CPM steels. So they went to Crucible to present to them. After talking it over and answering some questions, they were ready to begin. And at that point, it was just a waiting game. And it took just over a year for the first melt to make it to the powder stage. At that point, it took another 6 months to actually get it hipped and get it ready to be hot rolled and tested. Now, this was a fairly different composition from most others. And one of the most interesting differences, I personally think, is that in his studies, Larrin had found that while adding chromium does result in making the compound stainless, there is a threshold of usefulness with the addition of all the other elements, meaning that if you continue to add chromium beyond 10 to 13%, most of it ends up getting tied up in carbides and doesn't actually add any corrosion resistance to the final product. So, judging solely on the compositional makeup, most people are going to probably consider this a semi-stainless steel. But that they would probably be remiss, I would say, in assuming that, because the results in testing might tell a different story. We're going to get into that in just a little bit. Now, Magnacut is made up of 1.15% carbon, 10.7% chromium, 2% molybdenum, 4% vanadium, 0.2% nitrogen, and 2% niobium. The hardness capability of this steel is also amazing, with some examples reaching up to 65.5 Rockwell. It seems, though, on paper that the maximum toughness is going to be reached with the heat treat being somewhere around 62.5 Rockwell. Several knife makers have had this steel in hand and been testing it for months now, including Larrin himself, with pretty awesome results. Even after chopping a nail in two, Magnacut only suffered minor edge damage and was really easily sharpened and repaired on that edge, whereas other examples in 1095 really took a lot of work and could not be just sharpened right back up. Now, it has performed just as expected and beat out many of the current premium steels when tested for toughness and edge retention, which it's performed fantastically. But how would it hold up when tested for corrosion resistance? Remember how I said the chromium content was a little bit lower and technically doesn't meet that threshold for being considered stainless. Now, preliminary estimates showed that it would probably be somewhere between S35VN and S45VN as far as performance, but in actual testing, it far surpassed that, even performing better than 20 CV. And this surprised even Larrin himself. He attributes this to the lack of chromium carbides because of the composition and heat tying up the chromium content, which would render it less effective. It also was reported by all of the knife makers to be relatively easy to sharpen. It seemed to take a good edge, and burr removal was not difficult at all. This is all really good news as we all anxiously await its arrival in production knives, and that makes us all very excited to get our hands on it. Now, I must say, this is kind of interesting. Naming this steel obviously harkens back to Vasco, which developed many of the steels that we still see, know, and use today. They originally developed M4. They also developed steels like Vancut, Telecut, Redcut, and many others. So Magnacut seems to kind of fit right into that, which is, influenced a lot of the steels that we know and use today. Now, a little bit extra here. So we don't have anything in Magnacut in just yet as of the taping of this episode. Now, in just a few days, we're supposed to be getting in some Spyderco mules with the Magnacut, and we're going to be doing some torture testing on those. We're going to put them through their paces and see how they perform. Not only cutting, but also in corrosion resistance. We're going to put them in a bath of salt water and see how those things hold up comparatively with things like LC200N and Vanax. Those actually in testing were the only two steels, Vanax being H1 and LC200N, were the only ones that outperformed Magnacut in corrosion resistance in Larrin's testing. So we're going to put them to the test too, see how they do. We're also going to torture test it and see how it cuts, see how it holds up, and also sharpen it and see how easy it is to sharpen. So we're going to do our own testing there. That's going to be in a separate video. And remember, folks, as always, it's been TC here with Smoky Mountain Knife Works. Be sure to like, share, comment, subscribe. And remember, if it cuts like Magnacut, we carry it. What is up, everybody? We are back at the Daily Grind. What? Yeah, we're back at the Daily Grind, all right. There we go. All right.